Kaylin, you heard Brooks and I discussing timing as it pertains to remodeling and all the trends that are going on. Tell me a little bit about the timing that people are dealing with in the real estate market as it pertains to buying and selling right now.
Well, there's definitely been a little bit of a shift as the interest rates are starting to go up a little bit. All of a sudden, there's still the inventory issue for a lot of the buyers, but there tends to be not as many buyers out there right now. There tends to be some nerves that set in when their interest rate ticks up, even just a little bit. So even though, you know, for the most part, rates are still under 5%, that still does impact, you know, just the typical retail buyer's market right now. So you're starting to see that slow down a little bit. You know, the values are still tending to increase, not so substantially as we've seen in the last 6 to 9 months, but it tends to be a little correction, and there's a lot of speculation throughout the market of what it's going to do in the next the next 6 to 12 months. But so it's you know, I don't think there's too much knowledge of what's going to happen, but you know, definitely a lot of speculation.
What are some people speculating that will happen? I mean, what are people worried about, or what are they, I guess, excited about?
Well, I mean, from a lender standpoint, I mean, you could probably give me a better answer than I can give you. But you know, I think people are kind of bracing themselves for potentially another dip in the market as, you know, as the government starts to pull back some of the funds that they've put into the market. But you know, I'm not too savvy on a dip
in the real estate market.
Yeah, another dip in the values. You know, we've seen about the steady 10% increase in a lot of these areas, and you know, there's some speculation that they're saying that 10% is going to drop back down as the government starts to take back some of those dollars that they placed over the last couple of years.
I haven't heard anything like that, but I suppose that could be something some people are worried about. I mean, I've heard of maybe prices slowing, but you know, numbers have actually come out that it hasn't affected prices at all. It's only affected the buyer pool, but the buyer pool is so big that it hasn't affected prices. It's just taken people from 40 offers on a house down to like 10.
Right. Right, yeah, and I'm more relating to speculation. What people are you know, might be guessing is what might happen first part of next year and through 2014. You know, when it comes to the Pacific Northwest, I mean, we've always been a little more isolated to what, you know, what happens nationally. I mean, we have a strong economy and all that, but you know, I mean, it's at this point, you know, it's still I. You know, typically appreciate a little bit of the slowdown just because you can kind of get your bearings and it's a little more of an authentic market that you can begin to, you know, plan for and you know, you create your inventory and create your business model based on a real market as opposed to to manufactured you know, increases in value and everything like that. So
as people, you work with a lot of buyers and sellers. I mean, what questions are you answering right now as it pertains to the housing market?
Well, you know, honestly, Ben, I've been doing more of the, you know, my focus has shifted more towards builders, land acquisition. I mean, that market's heated up quite a bit. And so that's where my focus has been. So I really have not been dealing with too many buyers and sellers right now.
What are some builders' concerns, or what are some, you know, are they optimistic? Are they excited? What are builders saying? Because that's a pretty good leaders of the, you know, real estate industry. Their entire livelihood depends on it.
Yeah, I mean, I think it you know, typically breaks down to you know, to interest in cost of money and you know, as the market has picked up, I mean, things like building materials and cost of labor does go up. So builders' costs go up, land value goes up. So it's kind of difficult to speculate what you can pay for a piece of land as you're trying to determine what the price is going to be. If you can anticipate a consistent growth in the or consistent increase in value, You know, we're right now, it's difficult to rely on a consistent increase of value, because in a lot of these areas there hasn't been too much new construction, so you're kind of price setting, so it's hard to comp. And then so you combine that with increased costs of labor and materials and interest rates that are beginning to tick up. It definitely makes you think a little harder for the land that you're purchasing. So that's one issue that, you know, particularly Brooks and I, as we've been looking at deals, have been running into. The floodgates opened kind of earlier this year, where you're pretty much buying everything you can get your hands on, and there's a lot of competition. But then as the market starts shifting again like this, you got to be a little more conservative.
Sure. Galen, thanks so much for joining me, man. I know we got to chat with you just in a brief time, but, it's always interesting to hear the perspective, because a lot of people, you know, you're the boots on the ground in the builder world. So understanding what's going through their worlds right now is key.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks a lot for the call.